What's going on, guys? I think I came up with an idea on what I want to do. This is a set of L-29 heads that I got off of my... I have a Gen 6 454. And I think I'm going to use these heads in place of the peanut ports that are on the 454 in the black truck. Now, I've put up a video of these a while back, and a lot of people were like, oh, those are Gen 5 heads. They're not. They're Gen 6. Had other people say that they're peanut ports. They're not. This is 12-12 gasket. And as you can see, they are not peanut ports. They are full size. So, anyhow, I apologize in advance. This video is going to be kind of all over the place. I've got some stuff I want to show you and explain to you why I want to do what I'm doing. So, I've had these heads for a couple of years, and pretty much I haven't really done anything with them except for just let them sit here. So, I'm going to try to stare down in the ports if I can. Let you guys see what I can see. Which, no, it's not working. Of course. What? It worked in rehearsal, damn it. So, well, it's not working now. There. All I did was just hit these with a Dremel real fast, just to kind of clean them up, and just to knock some of the rust down. But anyhow, the main reason I want to go with these, in case you guys don't know, the L-29 head, or the Gen 6 head, has an incredibly tiny combustion chamber. That's a 100cc combustion chamber. I know it's hard to tell, but this is... that's all quench. And it's got a little tiny quench pad there. Nothing to write home about. But most of the time, you know, these things are like this. You know, and most big block heads are between 120cc, 119 to like 123. Well, this one being 100 is definitely going to raise the compression up. Right now, the compression I have with the engine that's in my truck is 7.6. And that's only because I don't know if it's a 38 or a 40,000 thick head gasket. Well, with this cylinder head, stock pistons that are in the truck, this 20,000 thick shim head gasket, which is made for a, you know, a 70s big block Chevy. Sorry, I'm all over the place. That didn't work. There we go. That worked. Alright, so this is just made for a plain old big block Chevy, so you can run Gen 6 heads on a 70s 454 without any gasket issues. It's not like the Gen 5 where you had certain gaskets and shit that you had to use. This is just a cheap Mr. Gasket 1131G 20,000 shim, you know, that are 12 bucks a piece or whatever, like what GM used from the factory. So that's kind of my plan. It's a little bit bigger valve. It's a 207 versus the 206 in a peanut port. Obviously, it has a lot bigger ports than a peanut port. It has a better exhaust design. If you notice, that's a D-ring, or a D-ring, yes. It's a D-shaped port. Granted, it needs, I mean, there's a lot of room for improvement in there. You know, that boss is pretty substantial. And when you look down the intake hole, that's... that one's pretty substantial too. There's, I can't get it to. If you can look right at the end of the valve where it's clean, there is a huge partition in the way. See if I can highlight. Nah, I can't do shit with it. I'm sorry, but you just have to take my word for it. There, where it's kind of like a milky gray color in the 10, 11 o'clock position, that is a huge step. I don't know why it's there, but it's there. So, anyway, let me go over some facts. Okay, so this is taken right off of his website. And I will go down and do my best to show you. So basically, it doesn't list my peanut ports. My peanut ports are 045s. Which is probably because they're so shitty, they don't even advertise them. But the L-29 head... It says it has a 230 in, or 230 intake port, which is considerably bigger than any of the peanut ports, if you notice. That means very little to me, but intake exhaust valve, combustion chamber of 99, and there's your flow numbers. Okay, so the head's completely out of breath by 6. Which is fine, because my camshaft that I'm planning on using is only half inch lift. Now, when I tore my 73 block apart, I noticed that it had Permatex all over the head bolts. And it also had a double roller timing chain. So I pulled this cam out of it and never messed with it. Just left it sit. Well, as it turns out, I threw calipers on it the other day. That is a 500 lift cam. I don't know what the duration is. I don't know how to measure that, you know, at home. But it's a 500 lift cam, so I'm pretty sure it's not factory. So with this cam in my 1.9:1 ratio rockers, I'm actually at like 530 lift. 530, 520. I don't know if it's intake or exhaust. I didn't really care. But so I've already got a camshaft. I've got those heads, bumped the compression up. That's the next step. I will get to that right now. So there's my compression. This is just off Summit's website. With the stock head, the stock peanut port heads that are on it, I'm given a 6cc dish. That's approximately what they are. 40 thousandths thick head gasket, 25 thou in the hole. And as you can see, it's a dismal 7.45:1. Less than 7.5:1 compression. It's no wonder why those motors were so sluggish. So in here is with the L-29 heads. Same 4.25 by 4-inch bore, or 4.25 bore, 4-inch stroke. 100cc. Same size pistons and everything. And we're at 9:1. Now, I know that is, you know, that's not a monster high compression motor, but to go from 7.5 to 9, that's got to be a lot more efficient. So I think that's the plan. The main reason I'm even thinking about doing head swaps and all of this on my 454 that's in the truck, I can't get the headers to fit. The only way I can get the headers to fit is to jack the motor up. I don't have the means to lift it high enough. So either the engine has to come out, or the heads have to come off. And if the heads are coming off, I might as well replace them with some good heads, or better heads. Now I know somebody's like, hey, what about those Promax heads? Not on a 7:1 or an 8:1 compression motor. No, I'm not wasting those. And I think these will be just fine. Yes, I know they're heavy, but so what? I don't know. I think with a half-inch lift cam, these heads, my Performer RPM air gap ripoff that I have, my Assault, and like a 750 or 800 quarter jet, whatever I have, I think it'll be a happy little street motor. What do you guys think? So, I do have a review, like I said, on my channel, these L-29 heads. I think it says Vortec big block Chevy heads or something. I was so incredibly smashed in that video that I was going to take it down the next day, but it had like 500 or 600 views. I'm like, oh, well, people are interested. Unfortunately, I was being a complete ass clown in that video, so I probably should have taken it down. But I don't recommend you go look for it. It's not a good video. But none of my videos are really all that great. But let's see. I'm sure somebody probably is already screaming at their TV about this, or their computer. Yes, that's not rust. That's actually wood. I used these things as a sawhorse when I was building my workbench. So anyway, these do have screw-in studs. Non-adjustable screw-in studs. Now, correct me if I'm wrong. These are a 7/16 stud. Can I take these studs out? Well, I mean, obviously these come out. I mean, they're finger tight. Can I take the stock ones out of my peanut ports and put them in here? Now I'll have adjustable rockers. If somebody knows the answer to that, please let me know. Now, I don't plan on doing a spring swap on these because these are designed to handle the weight of a roller lifter because the Gen 6 is a roller motor. So, you know, the roller cam is way heavier, way more aggressive, or not cam, I'm sorry, the lifter is way more aggressive, way heavier, and the cam is way more aggressive. I'm pretty sure these tiny little springs will hold up to that little half-inch lift cam. I think I'll be just fine. I know there's a bunch of videos. Richard Holdner was talking about these L-29 heads, or Gen 6 heads, as he calls them. He's got some of his older videos, like before he went off on his own. They did a Speedmaster top-end kit swap, and then they also did a Gen 6 swap where all they did was just throw a comp cam in it. And with these heads, they took it from 325 horse to 425 just by doing a cam. And then, like, in a month or so later, they did another video with the same engine. And they did a Speedmaster head swap and cam and intake and everything. And they made the same exact power. So these make the same thing as the Speedmaster heads do. But I mean, that's neither here nor there. But the Speedmaster heads are 122cc. So, you know, you lost a lot of compression, but... So, well, anyway, at this point in time, I'm kind of rambling, but please let me know, what would you do? What are your thoughts? These cylinder heads have 40,000 miles on them. Actually, the whole block only has 40,000 miles. The owner of this thing bought the truck, didn't check the oil, took it to some oil change place, and they put 5 quarts in an 8-quart motor and spun a bearing. And I got the motor as a core for $100 with the heads and everything. So, and they still even have the head gaskets on them. But, so that's all the schmoo that's on them. That's it. That's not bad. Oh, and these are shitty 882 heads, in case anybody was wondering. Those are just small block Chevy smogger heads. All right, well, let me know if you guys, what you guys would do. I appreciate it. If you made it this far, you're awesome. I appreciate it. Got to get the length of those views, you know what I mean? All right, thanks. See you in the next one.